against the best guys in the world. And now I'm gonna beat the best guys in the world. And that's just how I see it. I posted a video on my Instagram and I was running real fast. Like I did about 25 yards in only like 3-4 seconds. And they were just like, wow. And they were like, you think you could set a record? And I was like, sure, if you want me to try it. Guinness World Records is there, everybody's there. Former Olympians, former world record holders are all there supporting me, hyping me up, getting me going, and then I just took off, man. And the crazy thing was, my first one was actually faster than my second one. I was moving so fast, and then I slid into it and ducked under the sensor. So I had to go do it again. I was expecting, I was like, y'all don't understand, like, I'm gonna be under 5 seconds, maybe even under 4, and I called it. First thing I said, the second I was done, I looked at all of them, I said, I told you exactly what I was about to do, and I just did it. To be a Guinness World Record title holder, I'm number one. You know, there's nobody faster than me right now. I'm the fastest man on their hands in the world, but at the same time, it also means that my family's winning, my town's winning, and my support group's winning. So I was born with caudal regression syndrome. It's a very rare disease. I always work with what I got because I don't really have any of the cards that are dealt to me. A lot of people say foster mother. I'm not a big fan of that because she is my mother. The foster care system reached out to my mom, said that we exhausted all our options and that could you take in this boy? And then, man, about 7 months later, the conversation came up about me being adopted, and a week after that, I was just like, yeah, this is it, this is what I want. 5 years later, and it's the best thing that's ever happened to me. Well, I did get bullied when I was a kid. I got shoved in a locker. I've been beat up, where I was just like, you know what, I'm not gonna be weak anymore, and then I just put in the work as much as I could every day. I was going to 2 or 3 wrestling practices a day for 7 days a week. Man, by the time my senior year of high school came around, I became one of the best guys in the state. Soon after that, I became one of the best guys in the country. I'm really willing to put it all on the line to achieve my top goal of being the best wrestler, being the best track athlete. It's usually not the first choice for most people, given it's the world's most dangerous and oldest sport, and I just thought it looked fun. Everybody just accepted me in as one of them. They didn't look at me as I was different. They went hard against me just like I wanted them to, and the wrestling world really close family worldwide, and that's what I love.